Hello, and welcome to this preview session for upcoming RSA Conference 2015 on Industrial Control System Vulnerability Trends. My name is Amol, and I'm Director of Vulnerability Labs at Qualys. So, what are industrial control systems? These are systems that are everywhere around us. They could be carrying power to our homes, they could be manufacturing our cars, they could be any small or mid-scale manufacturing plants, they could be systems that control dams, or any type of control systems. Some of the examples you can see right now on your screen. So in this session, what we'll do is we'll take a quick look of the various industrial control system vulnerabilities. We start by this chart, which shows by numbers, the number of vulnerabilities from about 2011 area. ICS vulnerability is still a pretty new area, and before I would say 10 years, these vulnerabilities were not tracked very accurately. That's why you see such low numbers in 2009 and 2010. It's not because there were no vulnerabilities, but there was not a good tracking mechanism by which these vulnerabilities could be tracked. And at the end, on 2015, this is just an estimate of what vulnerabilities we expect to see by the end of this year. So if you look at industrial control systems in a little bit of detail, what you see is all industrial control systems are different. But there are some similarities. For example, most of them are made of these four components, which are basically data acquisition components, data conversion, communication, and control. By acquisition, I mean sensors, meters, field devices, devices that typically gather data like temperature, pressure. Conversion components include PLCs, IEDs, RTUs, which carry this data through various communication channels to the SCADA master or HMI. And in the presentation, you will also see various examples such as this for example, data acquisition, where there were some vulnerabilities in data acquisition. You'll also see a lot of examples for data conversion, where PLCs or IEDs had some vulnerabilities into them, which allowed attackers or which could allow potential attackers to take either partial or complete control of the system. And finally, we'll also look at various communication vulnerabilities. This chart just shows some of the communication vulnerabilities that were found in 2014-2015 timeframe. The number one communication component that we see are the DNP3 components, followed by SSL, HTTPS, so on and so forth. And finally, going to the last component, presentation and control. This is something that was a surprise to us. We went into this research expecting that there would be a lot of sensors, PLCs, and those type of vulnerabilities. But the surprise was that most of the vulnerabilities that we found were in data presentation or the HMI layer. And these vulnerabilities are very similar to the vulnerabilities that we see on a day-to-day basis in our IT infrastructures. So vulnerabilities in web applications, vulnerabilities in thin clients, web application vulnerabilities like cross-site scripting, SQL injection, directory traversal, so on and so forth. So overall, if you see vulnerabilities by these various components for industrial control systems, we found a whooping 63% of vulnerabilities in control, followed by 21% in communication, followed by very few vulnerabilities in PLCs, IEDs, which are just about 14%. So to conclude, industrial control systems are challenging. There are a lot of challenges, including these systems connected or exposed to the internet, older industrial control systems, which are not really designed for security but built for performance, now being used in a very open sort of way where security is a primary concern. The slides or the presentation at RSA conference will also go in detail on A lot of things that you could do in immediately after you go back to your work, or things that could be done in a week's time frame, or things that could be done in a month's time frame. Some of the things include patching, password management, configuration, security training for engineers, technicians, administrators, how to patch off-the-shelf software, which includes operating system, databases, web servers, and finally doing a comprehensive vulnerability and risk management audit, which and complying to security standards for your industry. So in short, the presentation will have all the components and all the configuration settings that you have been looking for, as well as various remediation techniques and vulnerabilities that we have seen in the last month or so. And I hope you join me at the RSA Conference 2015 in Singapore.